Maybe you've heard about a license-free standby replica, but did you know it's now available in Azure SQL Database in preview? Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Rajesh. Rajesh, thanks so much for coming back on the show.
Thanks, Anna. Thanks for having me.
Of course. And today, we're going to talk about something new in Azure SQL Database, and this is related to a standby replica. So I won't steal the thunder. Rajesh, tell us about it. What is
it? Thanks, Anna. So this is all about license-free standby replica. This is something that customers have been asking for a very long time, and we're excited to announce public preview of license-free standby replica. So we are very happy to announce this and make sure that customers can now start creating standby replica for SQL DB, and we'll go over in detail on what it is.
Awesome, cool. So maybe can we give like some background on like where this falls? We talked about the pillars in our last episode. Folks, you should check that out for HADR, but where does this kind of fall?
That's a great question. So that's a good segue to get into. We'll quickly touch upon what is disaster recovery and then what pillar that does it fall into. And then we'll talk about license-free standby replica and also have a demo to show how things work out.
Awesome.
Right. All right. So this is a slide that we covered in our earlier episode. We talk about three pillars of business continuity: availability, high availability, and DR, which is disaster recovery. And high availability is customer configured, same is the case with disaster recovery. And in disaster recovery, it provides redundancy across regions. As you can see here in this small diagram here, you will see disaster recovery being configured between two regions, primary and secondary region. And this is for a failover group deployment. Now, the key message or the key dimension to look at business continuity is, as you move from left to right, the business continuity goes up. And customers in some regulated industries, for various reasons, they do need to have disaster recovery in place. So that's something that is governed by those industries. Right? Now, what we have seen in many cases where customers create secondaries is most of the secondaries are predominantly used for failovers. There are some workloads that do have read queries routed to secondaries, but pretty much most of them need it for either compliance reasons or need it only in the event of a failover, or they use it for DR drills, which is again a common practice that many enterprises and SMB customers do. And setting up DR, this was a feedback that came in directly from customers, is it doubles the cost because you need to replicate your deployments from a primary and then create a secondary that's equally sized to primary, which is the recommended way, and that hinders adoption. Right? If you look at SQL DB's cost structure, infrastructure cost is about 60, and what I mean by infra is about the compute, storage, and stuff like that. And then we also charge the SQL IP, which is part of the license line item, and that's roughly about 40%. Now, what we are introducing is a license-free standby replica, which does not have any license costs. So right off the bat,
big savings.
Yeah, that's closely about 40% savings that customers get. And what we are saying is, as part of this public preview, we are saying customers can create one standby replica in general purpose and business critical, which is pretty much a significant portion of our deployments customers have. And then they can create one standby replica, get this 40% discount because they don't have to pay for license. Quick thing, we are extending this failover rights benefit from SQL Server on-prem. We did it for VMs, we did it for managed instance, now we are doing it for SQL DB as well.
Awesome.
And one of the key takeaways, this is a key differentiator compared to competitors. That's one of the neat benefits with SQL DB, is we control the license component, and then we have decided to take off this license and extend the failover rights benefit.
Yeah, because a competitor can't
do that.
Wipe
exactly.
The license phrase. Only we can do things like that. So it makes a lot of sense. And then I just wanted to call out, like, if I'm understanding this correctly, this is primarily for general purpose and business critical because we recently announced the license-free hyperscale tier, right?
Yes, that's right.
Got it. Awesome. Cool.
All right. Quickly touching upon, so what can you do with a standby replica? So this is one of the questions that many customers were asking in the preview. So this is only used for DR. So you can only use a standby replica only in the event of a disaster recovery. You can run DR drills, but you shouldn't be running any production applications connected to standby replica. You could run like maintenance operations. If you're interested, run CheckDB, which again, in a PaaS world, doesn't make a lot of sense. You can run your monitoring applications. You can run your DR drills, because that's one of the primary reasons why customers set up DR. They want to make sure that they exercise DR drills once in a while, and that's totally allowed. But other than that, you cannot connect and run any read queries. But if you just leave it there for the event of a DR, then you're good.
So the key word is standby, yes. Not read.
Exactly. There you go, Anna. You
got it. I got it.
All right. So let's quickly jump into a demo. I'll show you how quickly it is, how easy it is to set up a standby replica. So I'm in my portal. Let me get some real estate. And I'll show you what I have. So I have a database. This is in West Europe. And here's my server, and here's my database, right? So nothing special, just a plain vanilla database. Now, if I go into the replicas page, and then hit create replica, you'll see an option to create standby replica. Currently in preview, as it says, this resides on a different logical server. It allows you to create DR in the event of a failover, cannot serve read queries, does not incur additional cost. So if you're fine, you agree to the consent, you pick the server, select the server. So my primary is in West Europe, and my secondary, I'm selecting it to be North Europe, and then go review create, right? And then you can see the cost that you'll have to pay for it. Now, let's do the same thing, but let's create a geo replica, which is a full-blown secondary, right? And then you can see the price difference. So I'm still here, I'll pick the same server, and then if I go into my review cost, you see the price difference. That's about 40% more expensive than a standby replica. And then once you're done, you go hit create, and then standby replica will be created. In the interest of time, I already created a standby replica for an existing database. And then you can see some of these things show up in Portal 2. So when you go to the same database, and again, this was created between West Europe and North Europe. North Europe is my secondary. And then you can see the replica here is, the replica here is standby, which is saying it is a standby replica. And then the primary database to which the standby belongs to, right? And then if you hit up the replicas page, you will also see this information flowing through there as well. As you can see here, you have the standby replica section, and then it shows what is the database, what's the primary server, and so on and so forth. So that's pretty much how easy it is to create a standby replica. And then once you have a standby replica, all other operations just continue. So you will still have an option to failover,
nice.
Which is needed in case if you want to do some drills, because in a planned failover, we don't do any data loss. So that's something that customers do. And in the rare event of an outage that's impacting your primary, you do a forced failover. You look at a potential data loss and then bring your DR back up online.
Yep. Awesome. Cool. Well, this is really cool. I learned a lot. So I think like the big takeaway for me is like if you need DR for your scenario and you don't need read scale, then this is a great, much more affordable option for you to get that customer configured DR.
Exactly. For a long time, we have heard feedback directly from customers that setting up DR is expensive, and this is our effort trying to listen to customers and then making sure we deliver this cost-effective DR option. So that way, you can have a standby replica that's always ready for you in the event of an outage.
Awesome. Cool. Well, Rajesh, thanks so much for coming on the show. Any resources for folks to keep bookmarked or keep in mind?
That's a great question. So what we have done is we have published a comprehensive documentation with how to get started in Portal, PowerShell, CLI, and we also have a comprehensive FAQ. So if you go to that link, it should take you directly to the standby replica, and then you can read up and get started.
Thanks so much, Rajesh. I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers learned a lot. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, let us know what you think, and check the description for links to learn more. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.